Welcome to the Key Chapters of the Bible podcast. This is a daily podcast that's going through the key chapters of God's Word.
We are continuing our study in the book of Job and looking at one of life's most difficult questions. The question is, why do bad things happen to good people? Now we're going into Job chapter 38, and you might remember the setting behind this chapter or what's leading us to this point. Way back in Job chapter 1, we find out that Job was a righteous man who was healthy, wealthy, and wise. And in chapter 1, the Lord allowed Satan to take away Job's wealth. And then in chapter 2, the Lord allows Satan to take away Job's health. And so he goes from a man of prosperity to such pain. Then in chapter 3, he laments the day he was born. He just is wishing he was never born. And that kicks off a cycle of conversations between Job and his friends where each one gives him counsel based on their own perspective. Each friend represents basically a different way of seeking wisdom. One friend, the oldest friend, Eliphaz, sought wisdom in age and experience. The next friend, Bildad, sought wisdom in tradition and crowds and what other people said. Zophar sought wisdom in righteousness, and Elihu sought wisdom in passion and spiritual zeal. And yet ultimately, none of their counsel was correct, and none of it answered Job's questions. Job's youngest friend, Elihu, was the last to speak, and he concludes in chapter 37 that God does not regard those who are wise in heart, and basically saying, if you think you're so wise, God's not going to really listen to what you have to say. And since Job had been casting shade over all of their counsel all this time, they all piped down. And then comes the Lord in chapter 38. And chapter 38 begins with God's answer to these attempts at man-made wisdom. Verse 1 begins with the Lord answering Job out of a whirlwind. Now, just let's pause and think about that. This has got to be a super loud voice. You got something like a raging storm going on all around them, and yet God's voice is perfectly audible for them to hear. And so the Lord addresses Job directly. Notice that verse 1 capitalizes the name of the Lord, and that's because this is the Hebrew name Yahweh. Now, what we don't really see since we skipped chapters 4 through 37, that the Lord's name has not actually occurred in the book of Job since all the way back to chapter 2. And so all of this reasoning through all of these chapters all this time about who God is and what he does, it's all this generic understanding of God. It's just based on man's general thoughts about God. It is not based upon personal knowledge of the Lord himself. It's not based upon having a covenant relationship with Yahweh, with the Lord himself. And so before the Lord can even address their questions about why bad things happen to good people, they need to understand who they're dealing with. They need to understand him, which the Lord then makes clear in verse 2. When he asks Job, he says, "Who is this that darkens counsel by words without knowledge?" Now again, this is poetry. We discussed a little bit yesterday in chapter 3. This is poetry here. This is condensed language that sometimes is hard for us to understand. We might miss what's just being said here. The Lord is basically saying, who is this who's just kind of babbling on and on, not really knowing what he's talking about? You're hearing stuff, but you're just casting darkness upon it. You're not bringing enlightened thoughts. You're bringing darkened thoughts to your reasoning. And so for the rest of this chapter and over the next several chapters, the Lord is going to instruct Job and his friends about who he is, who the Lord is. Notice as we look at this chapter here, how often the word who occurs. It's actually the very first word in the Hebrew text, especially in verse 2, verse 5, verse 25, verse 36, verse 37. It occurs 13 times in this chapter. It only occurs a handful of times in the rest of this book. And so this chapter, the key concept is who. And almost every time the word who occurs in chapter 38, it's referring to the Lord. And so that's just the key to chapter 38. Job needs to know who more than he needs to know why. And the Lord drills this point home over and over again with these questions of who. Who set the measurements of the earth, verse 5. Who laid his cornerstone, verse 6. Who carves the path of water, verse 25. Who gives wisdom understanding, verse 36. Before they can understand anything about why, they must understand who. And not only understand who, but also understand what God has already given to them. You can see this in verse 36 where it says, "Who has put wisdom in the innermost being or given understanding to the mind?" And the Lord's point is basically, if he is the one who gives us our ability to think and reason just to begin with, we should recognize that he has a superior wisdom to our own, and he has good and wise reasons for everything he does and everything he allows. And so chapter 38, we realize that the Lord is fully aware of Job's suffering and his questions, but the Lord doesn't swoop down and say, you know what, let me just explain what's going on so you can just learn to trust me. His answer is instead, let me tell you about who I am so that you can trust me. Now, you remember from this podcast in chapter 1 that I came to the Lord myself in tragedy, and I had to learn to surrender the question of why to the Lord. In many ways, the Lord was teaching me this principle here. The answer to our questions of why is who. We need to know who God is, who has the power to do anything. We need to know who God is that has the wisdom to do anything. We need to know who God is who has the goodness to do anything. And when we understand who God is, we will understand that whatever he does is good and just and wise. And we may not understand it until we are with him in glory, but when we are with him, when we do understand what he has done and why, we will agree with it. We will say that was the right thing to do after all. I agree with you, God. So that's chapter 38. This is a bit of a shorter podcast, but we're going to continue this line of reasoning tomorrow as we go to chapter 39. But here's something to be thinking about between now and then. Just take a moment and just prayerfully examine your own heart, your own beliefs, and just ask this question. Where are your beliefs about God coming from? When you think about God, what is the basis of your theology? It's often said that we are all theologians. The question is, are we good theologians? As very often, the people have wrong beliefs about God, and that wrong belief comes from things like maybe what their families taught them growing up, or what their friends say, or what they see in a movie, maybe even what they hear in church, or what they think sounds reasonable. Problem is, very often, our beliefs about God are wrong. And we can see in the account of Job here that believing wrong things about God or listening to wrong counsel about God or saying wrong things about God can have dire consequences on our spiritual health. You see, the pain and suffering that Job was going through began with the loss of his family, the loss of his wealth, but his pain and suffering was greatly exacerbated by wrong theology. His beliefs about God were rooted in personal opinion, popular culture, all these other things, and these wrong beliefs were torturing his soul. And so as we close out our time today, why not just go to the Lord and ask him to renew your mind in his truth? Ask him to purge you of any wrong beliefs, anything you're believing about God that's not true, not accurate, according to who he is. Ask that he might guide you through his word, that he might use his word to teach you right understanding about him, so that your knowledge about God is rooted in the revelation he has given to you and I and all of us. Well, we'll wrap things up there. I hope to catch up with you tomorrow when we look at Job chapter 39. Until then, thanks so much for listening. I hope you have a great rest of your day. We'll see you tomorrow. God bless.